Hey guys, it's Parker here, back with part 13 of Pyre. So let's commence the Liberation Rite. Once more, you have gained the fall of Solium. Or one among you may go free. But first, you shall have to prevail against the offense in the Liberation Rite. Reader, your companions gathered there under the fall, they shall be counting on you. Indeed, as the cycle of the rites turn ever faster, so too is our plan set in motion. My agents in the Commonwealth are beginning to cause a bit of a stir out there, and word has reached high places that the rites are ending. This is our chance, though let us not despair should victory elude us here. We shall make the most of whatever disguise they have in store for us. That is to say, good luck my boy, it's time.
Once more, the Nightwings gain the summit of the sacred Mount Aladiel to conduct the Liberation Rite, even as the stars themselves abandon you. Make good upon these final opportunities, reader. This glorious age-old tradition coming to an end upon your watch. I trust your adversaries, the Essence, shall not throw away this chance. Choose now who may go free, should they unfortunately fail.
The pyres burn, and each of the triumphers is present and prepared. I concur, the pyres burn, and each of the triumphers is present and prepared. Then, O Anointed One of the Sense, come forth now and declare yourself, and pay any respects you have unto your adversaries, the Nightwings. Tamita suits down for summer, and unfastens her mask. I am known as Tamita Dane. I mean to return to my ancestor home, and promptly resume my responsibilities as a flight tactician of the Highwing Remnants. Our long stalemate against the Commonwealth should soon be ended, should I and several of my sisters manage to rejoin our clan. Then, our vengeance shall be swift and thorough. Your quarrel with the country the Cassie took is beneath the nose of the scribes, Tamita Dane. Here, you shall be judged under the stars. My quarrel with the Commonwealth is all that they gave me and my sister strength enough to reach this point. The scribes all dwell take heed of how my people suffer. We are not weaklings anymore, like your Trieste deed is. We shall not fall in line with flightless fools and their naked attempts to subsume our heritage, our culture. Speak not again thus of the saint, or we shall be expelled, Tamita Dane. Tamita scoffs and turns her attention toward your side. And Nightwings, as for you, the fury we shall imminently show is nothing in comparison to the hatred going for your Commonwealth in the mountains on our side. She signals to her sisters to ready themselves. You stake your freedom, but there shall be nothing save for devastation should you manage to return. Nightwings, your decision. On whose behalf you shall conduct the Liberation Rite? Reader, I would ask you to choose wisely, but I'm sure you know no other way. And you, prepare your song, Tariq. Of course, Les.
Whom do you intend to liberate? Rookie.
Good choice there, chump. Don't forget out of here. I don't know what you're gonna do without me.
Who shall strive for him? Tamitha.
Alright, I'll see what I can do for him, Rita, darling.
Bertrude.
We shall lend our support to that one, then. Alright, let's go. One final obstacle to overcome, ere I can soar again above your Commonwealth. Such destruction as shall rain upon it soon. But first, let us dance this final time.
Commence! Yeah.
As the Liberation Rite continues, you sense Tamita reaching out to you, or perhaps just reaching out to anyone at all. Reader, someone, please, let her prevail. Let her prevail. Please, let her prevail here just once. If this thought makes me a traitor, so be it. But please, let Tamita prevail, for she is here, wrapped up in all this because of me. The plea trails off, and Tamita remains steadfast, all her attention focused on the Liberation Rite, and as for Tamita. Prepare yourselves, Nightwings, and as for you, Tamita, I await the outcome of this night, for I shall soon assure that I may never have to see your smirking countenance again. Hark now, my sisters, down what the book says, a vast historic formation. Prevail here against those wretches, no matter the cost. In disregard for the ways of rights, Tommy the Danus order of triumvirate to push further afield, adopting an even more aggressive stance for the remainder of this rite. Oh boy, Oh, that is not fair.
Their worth. They surpassed their adversaries in the end. Thus ends the Liberation Rite. And thus the scribes have chosen the exile appointed by the Nightwings shall be free. Absolved of all misdeeds, return to glory in the Commonwealth. His adversary and all others shall remain to carry out their rightful sentences.
Damn you for this, Tamita. All of this because of you. What now? I guess I'm just supposed to jump into this waterfall thing back here, and then that's it. All free! Something close over him then. Now listen to me, chums. So any of you go thinking you're gonna miss me, yeah? You're gonna do just fine. Even without old Ricky Greentail there to keep an eye on all the time. Even though the rest of you are just a bunch of soapbox and all that. Me, I can be so busy drinking my Sicilian Commonwealth stock, and I'm sure I'm soon gonna forget each and every one of you. But just in case I don't, you be sure and stop by and visit me if you get back here too. Just look for Mama Greentail's shop, right in the heart of town, you can't miss it. So yeah, stop by, say hi, you know. Now, I think I gotta go, so, excuse me. He drops Here's what it is. Although you still can hear him going on about something. Whoa, let me tell you, this is weird in here. Hey, Sardi. Uh-oh, wait. Rookie, earn back his freedom. May he return in glory.
Godspeed, Rookie Greentail. The eight scribes are watching from afar. By their grace, may the cycle of the rites keep turning for as long as possible. May the scribes have mercy on us all.
Well, Pamita, truly did you get the best of me again. Know that your actions for our sisters on the other side an even greater peril. Not that you care, of course. Yet, I am certain that they shall someday prevail, with or without my aid. To think that I was born to share blood with someone such as you. You return to the wagon after having prevailed against the offense in the Liberation Rite. That's one less mouth to feed. Would that we make good of all such incidents. You succeed in liberating Rookie, who returned to the Commonwealth in glory. We have but a few such Liberation Rites remaining. Exactly how many, I do not wish to speculate about as yet until such time as we could better say for certain. Under no circumstances would I suggest this is ideal. However, it is opportune enough that our plan may yet. As yet, succeed. Although, all these setbacks, I fear. Wolfert trails off and falls silent. Some of the others exchange looks, they're beginning to understand. With the rite soon ending, everything which Wolfert has thought, both on his own for many years and now with all of you, all of it may have been in vain. The hush spreads to the others. But not to you. You then proceed to do something none of them seem to expect. You raise your voice. Each of your fellow selves turns to you, their expressions asking you a question with no easy answer. What are we going to do? As you meet Pamito's gaze, the words for the occasion begin to crystallize in your mind. You are searching to find the right words, as all of your fellow selves are looking to you now. And are now poised to seize upon a glorious opportunity. Press the red seal to lock in your speech. You tell them that you all stood together time after time throughout this quest. Enough, okay? None of you pursued this quest with any guarantees. It is a quest you all knew was unlikely to end well. But something far more vital is at stake. You see the imminent conclusion of the rise of the sign. It's a sign that the world is changing. You now have this opportunity to live a purpose for your people, for all those who shall live on. When you look at it that way, which side of the world you end up on is up to all of you, to each one of you, in your own way. After a brief period of reflection, you share one last sentiment with the group. We shall reunite someday among the stars, then you join the others in silence. Thus, do you remain together with your thoughts? No one speaks for a time but then. Ah, the struggle you describe, O Master Reader, it has been glorious indeed! Wherever you shall lead, this night shall follow without stopping once even to think.
That is so.
You see them too then, Mister, the scribes among the stars, how they are watching over us.
Thou wouldst dare to change this ancient world, reading one, and yet thy words are tinged with certain truth.
May long the stars remain alight for you, reader, sir. All the while, Wolver remains watching intently. Then, his expression softens, and he smiles. You are right, of course, my boy. We are the Nightwings. It is precisely as you said. We shall reunite someday among the stars. Lead us then, reader, to the end of our quest, and the dawn of the new age for all our kin. Everyone, for the Nightwings! Everyone responds in kind. They stand with you no matter what. They await the outcome of your vision of the stars, which burn with renewed fury, because now, the last rites beckon. Each of the Nightwings gain 1+ hope permanently! We shall reunite someday. The stars above now burn with what appears desultory, many more than usual. Your path is yours to choose amid a myriad of stars. The stars of the eight skies, they shine together now as one. The little minister draws breath, as so surprised by what he sees. He backs away and averts his eyes. This is another sign the rites are soon to cease. Few chances yet remain to confront the officers you have met during your journey. Very well then, reader. Once more, you shall face the Dealish and the Pyrehearts when next the stars align. We may set course to the Isle Camera at dawn. For now, please get some rest in the remaining dark of night. After the Liberation Rite, you find Sir Gilman in an uncharacteristically quiet and contemplative mood. He salutes you crisply with his tail. Glory to you, Master Reader, and glory to the noble rookie Greentail, long may prosper in the Commonwealth, and in so doing, may benefit to the plan into which we have all been thrust. Then he falls silent for a time. He senses growing more emotional. And noble rookie, this night found a kindred spirit, Master Reader, one of the questionable honor, the greatest cunning, and such blinding speed as to befit a minstrel's tale. This night fears that a triumvirate lost something irreplaceable in him. Of course, this knight is supposed to please that rookie has achieved his freedom, very much so. And furthermore, this knight shall now continue training even harder than before. Rookie Greentail, this knight shall train on, and until such time as he is slithered in the giant lightning, such as this is tempest! Now, Master Reader, this knight must beg his leave of you, for it is time not for his rest, but for his training. Know that he is very grateful for your wisdom and your guidance and rights. Between yourself and Master Rookie, you have instilled within his mind an unshakable resolve. He bows low, bids you good evening. Let us continue our journey. There is no time now to return to Moonlight Alcove as before, as the stars already urge you on, everyone is ready to make haste with the Isle Camera. Wolfred approaches. As you fly above his hidden lair at the Moonlight Alcove, you can't help but wonder if you shall ever return to Earth. There, our dear Alcove, I ask my agents to break down the place. It soon shall be gone, if it isn't already. We shall not be returning, or we've not the time to do so anyway. And, with Orlok back among the living now, and no longer fond of me, I dare not think that you'll do with it. Unfortunately, hiding places are of little value once they're found. Once all this is over, those of us who did not manage to return, we shall have to find another place to live, to try to live at least. Again, we return to our chamber hidden in storm. I have met very few who know of it at all, much less have walked upon its stones and sands. This is the Discord sorting. Tales of the demise of Kaelmer Rovecaller, who met his band there on the isle. The imps that storm and breed across the place today seem not to mind. Having paid witness to the rites firsthand, they have become rather obsessed with it. I sometimes wonder if it is more difficult to conduct the rites with such a boisterous audience. May the pirates find their way shortly, so that the imps may have the contest they desire. After having reached the balanced waters of Bar of Reef, you volunteer to survey the grounds to prepare to head out. However, your companions beat you to it in this case. Easy does it, reader darling. Sir Gilman and I were thinking we would take this one. They depart, leaving you to rest up. When they later return with nothing much to report, you are feeling better and in the midst of deciding which of your vacations to pursue. Halt! Everyone, I beg you please forgive my rudeness here. The Black Wagon shuddered to a stop en route to the Isle of Camer. There is some commotion as the old minister motions for everyone to be still. Someone is there, along our path, ahead. He points to the distance. However, when you scan the horizon, everything is still. He sees no sign of whomever the old minister referred to. Still, he indicates caution. Strange. I do not believe I was mistaken. A tense moment passes, then another. Then, the old minister tenses up. Our guest, he is there. You look toward where he signals, and then alas, you see the cause of his concern. There's no mistaking who it is. Aurelic stands there, near motionless, atop some forgotten rock jutting from the murky waters a fair distance away. He stands directly on the passage of a black wagon, yet he shows no sign of acknowledging the wagon's presence. He appears only to be waiting for something, likely for you all. The old missile gets your attention, quietly. Reader, what do your senses tell you this time? Aurelic may have come with ill intent. Aurelic stands in your path. What shall you do? Let's hail him. There has to be a way to reason, Aurelic, and bridge differences between him and his former triumvirate. Perhaps he has come to negotiate. Perhaps you are correct. Let's try and make contact with him, then, as he proceeds. You give the signal for the drivers to start the wagon and head toward him. But, just see you reach the point where Aurelic once did. It seems our guest has already departed. Let us remain watchful as we proceed on course. Indeed, Aurelic is nowhere to be found now. The unnerving encounter causes everyone to fall silent for the remainder of the trip. Your wagon finally arrives at the Isle of Camer, where still there is no sign of Aurelic, or your next adversaries for that matter. Your companions organize a quick search about the premises, leaving you to watch the wagon until the ride's commencement. Something is wrong. Someone is here, alone, with you. Oh, hey there, Aurelic. Aurelic seems to be examining various objects in the wagon. Whether he has noticed you, you cannot tell. What is he doing here? How he got it unnoticed, you cannot imagine. You watch him go about whatever he is doing, examining all sorts of things that you and your fellow exiles gather on your journey. He shakes his head. SMH. All of these trinkets. This wagon is most different now. Welcoming, and yet I am unwelcome here, it seems. In my own wagon. He directs his gaze at you, acknowledging your presence for the first time. You, a mere shadow. Tell me something. Who are you to them? Aurelic wishes to know your connection to the Nightwing. Say you are their friend. You tell Aurelic they have traveled all across the downside with this group and count them as your trusted friends. It is a different group now than in his day. A friend, is it? Beware then, for the Nightwings do not always treat their friends with all due charity. Relay to them a message for me, Shadow. Tell them I shall have my knight. He starts right past you toward the door, but then he turns to you once again. Once more. I shall have my knight. Then, Aurelic is gone. Several of your companions return as you exit the wagon. You explain what happened. However, none of them saw Aurelic. Most concerning, reader. Though I am thankful you are well. Aurelic, he always was a peaceful individual, and yet his disposition is much different now. Perhaps we had best inspect the wagon for any signs of tampering in light of these events. You and the others conduct an exhaustive search in and around the black wagon for any signs of objects missing or tampered with, as well as signs of damage or foul play. Search yields something. No one finds any sign that anything was moved or tampered with. Even the driving seemed calm. Then it leads to questioning your own recollection of what happened. You try to clear your mind, for the ride is soon now to commence. Whoa, guys, let me tell you something real quick. Now, I haven't been down to heard that Mr. Greentail is moving on or something like that, right? Well, I just thought, you know, he'll still refer to customers because, give me the same great deals, okay? I'm pretty sure you're doing business, and you guys be sure to tell your friends, okay? You stand before the bizarre outcroppings of the Isle Camber. The sky darkens, and in the distance, you hear the sound of gibbering creatures growing louder. The sound of it is unnerving enough that your fellow exiles remain quiet, their eyes are fixed to the stars above. Soon, something in the sky above begins to stir.
Reader returns, along with his remaining retinue of miscreants. You managed recently to rid yourself of yet another one. Your adversaries, the Pyrehearts. As with you, they must be very desperate for their freedom. They shall not make it any easier from here.
Again, he cut it to torment us? This is really gonna happen again, isn't it?
Your adversary is a prayer reader who shall conduct the rites on your behalf.
Choose now, your band of traitors! May.
Castia?
Bertrude. It is done.
We await the ancient rites commencement. Well, we are not afraid of you, especially not this night. Worm knights attack!
Begin. A favorable start. That Bertrude's faster than she looks. There. Onward thus to greater glory. Bertrude plunged into the adversary's pyre. The rite is nearly ended. And it is done. The Nightwings managed to prevail. May their next adversaries fare a little better. The ceremony is complete.
Now then, if you can't finish making for sport of us, then we shall slither away in the humiliating disgrace of the thing.
Bask now in the wisdom of the scribes. May misfortune find you ere the turning of the stars.
Back at the Black Wagon, you find Illuminus examining your fellow exiles after they prevailed against the Pyrehearts of Great Prowess. It is plain that none of them look well. The Illuminus notices you and turns to you. Reader, the faster turning of the cycle of the rites has put a strain on everyone. We have multiple cases of banishing sickness this time. It is fortunate that your other companions are available to conduct the coming rite, because I fear that this group here requires rest. You bid Sir Gilman a swift recovery, and he nods weakly in response. You exchange a look of Bertrude, who seems exhausted after the last rite. Master May, it is clear to you that she wishes to be left alone right now. You lead the lone minstrel to look after them, and turn your attention to the stars that remain shining in the dark outside. The stars yet shine for you, revealing various paths forward. You gaze into the darkness of night. The stars reveal to you a path toward the spring of Jomir, where the rite shall soon continue. Come morning, your travels shall continue. For now, everyone needs rest. The Theater Crystal seeks Fulfrith. My love reader comes to me again. To what do I own the pleasure? Please, reader, leave me be. I ask that you leave me be. Go about your business. Go. Watch the stars die out and get your idiots their freedom. And you be sure to tell that Heron with whom you consort that Sandra the Unseen did her job. You tell him that. Perhaps that way she put in a good word, and the sky shall finally provide for me a bit of reprieve. She falls silent for a time. I do not know what else to do, reader. But you remain with her, letting her draw whatever strength and comfort from her thoughts as you are able to afford. That was kind of you. However, let us conduct our business. I care not for your pity. Do not come visit me again, like this, without my asking. I insist. Not a problem. Simply indicate who is to be my student for the time. Alright, Fulfrith. Let's go. You asked Sandra to administer one of her special trials for Fulfrith. That fancy talking sap, you mean? I shall be interested to see if he has learned something since last we sparred like this. Then, let us bring him forth. Soon, Wolfred appears, and he does summon. So it is my turn then, is it? Then let us see what we can do, my boy. The Operation Sandra appears and unfastens her mask. It's a well, Sap. You answer to me here. As you will, old Sandra the Unseen. Proper as ever then, though I wonder if you have the wherewithal that you project. Show me then, what you could do without the benefit of those whom you would lead, and let us see if you and your lovely reader have reached a thorough understanding as of yet. I am grateful for the privilege of your time, good Sandra. Battery shall never get any of me, Snap. Nonetheless, your performance is sufficient and you passed my test. Thus, congratulations are in order to you and to your lovely reader. Now, farewell. I have not seen that Sandra in some time. She has not changed a bit. Though it seems she left something for us, does she? Do we see Lou's bow? Well, that's cool. Accept the reward. Your intentions to explore the desolate sprawl of Fallflat were dashed when, on your arrival, several of the lagging strong-willed drive-ins escaped. Fortunately, their disposition toward mischief proves predictable enough, and soon all villains are once again accounted for. However, Wolfred also has a nasty bite to show for it. A few lusters among our drive-ins ranks is no cause for concern. You dressed a minor wound, which ought to heal soon, but the incident took much of your remaining time to stay, and left both you and Volver awaiting its merciful conclusion. No.
You are nothing, reader. Nothing but a mindless simpleton. Your every action is a stain upon the legacy of the eight scribes. The rites have been a long-held secret to keep out those such as you.
You wake from what little sleep you managed this past night. Once more, the voice tormented you within your dreams. You attempt to rid your memory of it. If the voice truly is that of the Arch-Justice Andropolis, the 11th, the 6th, I don't even know. I don't know Roman numerals. Himself, as Wolfert indicated, then none of you are likely to receive too warm a welcome, should you regain your freedom. A messenger with news and rumors from the other side comes huffing toward your wagon here in the rocky pathways of Jomir Valley. You let it in and offer it some light refreshment, as Ricky would have done. Then his message turns out to be about him. You learn Ricky's past transgressions have all been forgiven since he returned to the Commonwealth. He has offered a well-appointed home and place of business. It must have represented just the kind of lavish lifestyle that Ricky always claimed to have had for himself and his extended family. Eventually, in some reluctantly, however, he refused the gifts. Instead, he tracked down Wolfer's agents and gave them ample information, thus emboldening their ranks. The last bit of the message sounds as though it's transcribed word for word from something Ricky said. It simply reads, "The rest of you better get back here soon or else!" You think the messenger input a report. Soon it was all your companions. It has all your companions talking. I had every faith that our friend Ricky would stand tall and rise to the occasion. Hard to believe he would have turned out living in that kind of luxury, though maybe he got used to it out here. We understand this Ricky holds no small degree of influence, at least among his kind. Don't you think he must be sad to have turned out a house? I hope he isn't sad. Ah, the noble Ricky, he's such a shining example to us all! The news of Ricky's liberation fills you and your fellow exiles with newfound resolve. The messenger accepts some scraps to eat from you and rushes off. Wish, Ricky Reluck. Oh, it's you guys. Good. Because I was just thinking, I could use a customer real bad today. Just in general, you know? As the sky above the spring of Jomir darkens, your companions watch the signs and await the commencing of the rites. Tamito speaks up after a time. Never ceases to be awkward waiting around like this. Now everything is ready, and the stars begin to shine once more, precisely as foretold.
Rita, I am still very cross with you, you know. To think I saw in you a worthy heir. Not just to the legacy of the Nightwings, but to the future of the Commonwealth. That traitor Wolfred. Only a fool would be seduced by his audacious promises and his dangerous ideas. That, dear reader, would make you a fool. I have no choice but to explain it thus, so even you could understand. Now for this blasted rite. Some of us still have our duties to uphold.
The adversaries whom you are to confront, when instead you had your run-in with Orog, have assembled at the opposite side of the clearing, and the pyre burns bright. Lando emerges from the ranks of the accusers and calls out to the rest of you. You Nightwings, you thought that the demon tug you said to waylay us would be enough to stare us save us from our true past, you utter scum. Each time I think that I see the lowest depth of your treachery, you manage to surprise me yet again. The accusers seem all the more determined to prevail against you now. The Rolex denied their chance to stand against you last time.
Who shall besmirch the Nightwing's name? May.
Tamita?
Tamitha. Wolfred. If that is all, then.
Prepare yourself, everyone. Come, the Nightwings. We are prepared for you. Let's go, you guys.
Yes, begin. orb is up. The path to glory laid bare. The orb quenches the flame. Pamatha has doused the flame. With grace. Your pyre burns brighter for the while. Stand not in glory's path. Glorious. A true aimed thrust into the fire.
No, not again. I cannot lose to you again. This cannot be happening to me.
No, you don't. Such wherewithal. Once more like that, and we are finished here. And it is done. The blasted Nightwings prevailed somehow. And what a crushing victory it was. Thus end this night's proceedings.
Damn you, Nightwings. Damn you all.
There is much to learn from this experience. You may go now at your earliest convenience.
There proves little time for us at the Black Guard and at your fellow sides, thus the Accusers would ease. Those affected with banishment sickness seem to be doing better, at least, and express gratitude to the May, Pametha, and Fulfer for their efforts. Just then, the lone minister appears before you. No words escape his lips. You can guess full well what he has come to indicate to you, and fallen back out into the darkness. The stars above seem to be few and fading, and yet one still shines defiant. The path to freedom reveals itself once more. You noticed that the lone mister was standing there with you regarding the night sky, the great guardian eye. We have paid witness to the Liberation Rites upon the fall of Solian for a long time. We have seen so much, and so, I'm a bit taken back as all to see something which I have never seen. We look upon the stars together for a while then. I wish for you good fortune, and the wisdom it describes, on your ascent. The lone minister leaves you there alone under the night. It has grown very late, and you need rest. The Black Dragon shall have to take flight again come morning. Something appears different now, but the sacred mountain was severe. The lands near Emperor's Ascent and Emperor's Fall appear ashen. On the other hand, the once victorious regions below, which you know as Temple High Road and Temple Cistern, seem swept clean by the elements. The Lone Minister observes all this alongside you. Include whether we have let you see the reader, sir. We ought to be able to make landing close to the Skyscape now. So, then, I suppose this means we soon shall see Celeste once more. Then I shall go tell everyone to prepare for landing. You arrive once more among the narrow passageways of Mount Elodio. It appears that Dalbert and the Fae have already arrived along the other route. With some time spare after having landed, you join Pamita on a brief expedition to Emmanuel and Molten Millis. Why bother, Pamita, with any part of this? They're using you, same as you're using them, you know. But you're not using them. You're not using them. You're not using them. You're there because you want to be. You're there because you want to be. You return to Wagon when she has finished paying her respects. You have occasion once more to pursue your vocations. Accept the blessing. Again, you stand before Skyscape, where the gate guardian regards you all above an archway carved from stone, the styles of the Nightwings. You must know by now that, once the stars no longer shine, the rise shall cease. For now, step forth. Except for you, Tariq, you stay right there. Greetings, Celeste. The Nightwings are prepared, and as for me? You shall not blast me under the gate again. Do we understand each other, Tariq? Hey, Celeste, I apologize for my behavior before. I shall adhere more strictly to my duties. Be sure of it. Now, each of you, come forth. Please say your names and what is it that you seek while crossing Skyscape. One by one, your companions cross the gate until it is your time to do so, and you follow them in turn. The gate guardian regards you all, then waves you through towards the summit. Day skies bid the Nightwings welcome. Go forth to glory. Am I to free to accompany them, Celeste, or shall I remain here? She looks at him a while. You are free to accompany them, Tariq. As you will, Celeste, until we meet upon the summit then. Oh, it's you guys. Well, come on in. Guess we got here around time because I was just thinking. Maybe I'll close a little earlier, you know? This year has been real, real good. Everything is just, it's been a little slow in spots. A little slow is all I was thinking. Maybe I should have sailed. What would you say to that? Go for it. You suggested fucking around that sail might be a good idea to liven things up a bit. Well, I guess maybe that's the way to look at things, so then... I was gonna think about it still in a while, but no promises, okay? So, are you buying something here or what? That's why I gotta repeat a customer there, Dad. You give them a deal. Okay, guys, that'll be it for part 12, a Pyre. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you guys next time.